stiff neck, we have to create an angle. What we do is we pass the body. As I pass the body, I bring the fingers back to me to expand the wrist. If I just move it, he moves too, and then it doesn't work. So I need to cut across the body. Very simple. In the old days, in the Shaolin Kung Fu, it's a praying mantis technique. Like that. Very simple. This way too. Okay, so the secret is, don't go here because he gets strong and he can pull me. Across the body he can't pull because he pulls it into himself. Okay? So you need that angle. And there's the release. Very simple. Wishing your key is where you're held on the underside of your hand. It's very easy to release remembering the angles. So when all the holds come to the underside, even if it's that way, or the same hand, when you're held on the other, they call it Ushinoki. In Shaolin Kempo, really we don't differentiate the movement. We just call it Ukiwaza, because it's all done freestyle. So this movement's from the grab, whether it's grabbed on the inside, the outside, or cross hand,
is exactly the same.
In Chinese, it's called qinna, specialized set of grabbing and restraining. So we are separated as ukiwaza and gyakuwaza. Although they're both there, in Shaolin, the ukiwaza and gyakuwaza come together because as we take the release, we take the hold. If we're going to strike, then it would be just ukiwaza. Ukiwaza is where you push the hand down, thrust out to make the release. So you would combine this with an empty technique. Very simple. You might push it down using your elbow. So any technique that's going down for the release, like that, push the back away, like that, then come back. Or ukiwaza, this one, you look in, come up, inside, breathe, release. Or, you can use catch and pull, okay? Both hands must work the same time. From outside, close, keep here, push, very simple. Okay, up, here, push, up, use the release. Okay, first one, you need to be very short, come up, use the elbow, and release very quick. But the hand here must work same time. Okay. Then you can catch it. One key distance. Here. Very simple. The release is easy. Up. In. In. Okay. If we come to the outside, we can push in. Haki. Cross. One here. Take down. Okay. So when we go inside or outside, then cut. Okay. Cut. So nuki, nukiwaza means to release. Then you have gyakuwaza, which is where you actually take and lock the wrist.
Mano.
Okay. The angle is very important. If the arm is straight, it's not work. But when there's a slight angle here, just 1 inch, this has a lot of strength. So you have different methods. You can go one, pull down, or I sometimes create the angle by moving. When I move in, I already made the angle. Okay? Some people do here, and his arm goes straight. I can't do it. But when I have this small angle here, just this piece here, makes it very, very easy. They hold the dogi, so they hoki. So they hoki, sorry. So there's, whenever they hold the dogi, by holding the wrist very tight at the top, create pressure with your body. Okay? I don't do it with my hand. I hold it against my body, and I bend my torso, upper body, down. Then change direction. Very simple technique. We do it from this side now. One. Hold it on the joint here. Here. Twist down. Change direction using my leg and body weight. Quickly. Keeping it. Okay? Place the knee on the top of the head. End of the technique. Awesome. There's many, many different ways. Ude Noki is when he holds the arm. So if he holds my arm, this would be Ude Noki. Okay, if you hold the arm here, Ude Noki. If we hold the Dogi, Sode Noki. Okay, when they hold the Dogi, there's different ways. We can use the elbow for pressure. So as it comes, I block the hand here, I use my elbow. Pressure this way. This is very tight grip. Sudden change direction. We have the throw. Okay, so any grab on the doggy, so then okay. Normally, you can go all the way across, but sometimes they let go. So what I do is I go half across and then I put a little bit of angle there. You can hold it this way. Or you can bring in across the top. So what you need to do is you need to get familiar with what works for your angle and your body size. For me, I come here using the knife across the top. I keep my chest tight and I pull down. One. Take this hand here, elbow back of the head. So if it's quick. Okay. From here fast, you can bring down very, very quick. Okay, if I want to change angle, using my elbow, putting pressure, I can create angle. Holding it here, not relieving it, just by moving my body, I put pressure on his wrist. Same from the grabs. One, here, angle, pressure. Okay? No angle, no pressure. Don't work. Little bit of angle, pressure. Change direction, turn. Even if he holds a jacket tight at the top, same technique. Put the piece across here this way and here. Use body weight. So as he holds tight, body weight. Very, very simple. Very easy. So from all these movements that I did, all I really did was create pressure here on the wrist, on the different parts of the wrist. Here is enough to take down. Okay? Here is enough to bend. Here lifts. So when someone holds me, I decide what I want to do. I want to pull around this way. See the angle I created? That way. I want to take down this way. I want you to elbow pressure this way. So very, very simple. Even for grabbing the throat, first I pull the hand down. I use the same technique. Hand up, hand down. Watch. One down to protect. Finish. As I'm pulling it down, I'm taking it off my throat. As I'm pulling it down, I take it off my throat. I actually hold his hand there. I don't pull it away. I hold it there. While it's there, he's confident he's still got me, but I know I got control. Angle down. Very simple, then twist down. So when you're doing Nuki Waza, it needs to be automatic. Okay? Don't say, okay, hold me here, hold me here, hold me here. You stand there and he just grabs whatever he wants and you need to react. You're judged on how fast you react to whichever way he's going to grab you. Ankles.